to intermediate level English language arts.
Hi guys and welcome to English language arts grade 6. Our topic for today would be identifying noun clauses. All right. So, first and foremost, what are noun clauses? Noun clauses are basically dependent clauses, but they are used differently. They are used to replace a single word in a sentence. They are either group of words, they are a group of words but are treated as just one noun. Just one noun. So that means they can either be used as either the subjects or the objects of a sentence. Example. Here are some examples of noun clauses used as a subject. The information is very important to us. I underlined the subject there, information. But if you'd like to be specific about the information, you can go, what Sir Vince taught us in class is very important to us. Right? Okay? Oh, I forgot. It should include, the underline should include up until in class. But anyways, what Sir Vince taught us in class, that is your noun clause. That simple word right there just refers to one thing, the information. Next, whatever you wish, your wish is, whatever your wish is my command, right? You hear this in like what, genies and stuff, like stories about genies and whatnot, right? So whatever your wish is my command. Whatever your wish, that's one thing. So whatever your wish is, it's just one, right? And that is your command. It stands as a subject. What I say is true. Again, what I say, so that's just one thing. Whatever I say, it's just one thing. But it's treated as a subject. It's treated as just one word. This clause right here, what I say. This is a noun clause used as a subject. How about use as objects? So you can have three. Direct objects, indirect, and objects of the preposition. And for direct objects, we learned that pandas are not anymore endangered. That pandas are not anymore endangered. Here, we have this phrase right here. This clause right here. Sorry, it's a clause, right? And this clause refers to just one thing. Learned what? Learned what? That's your direct object right there. Underline the whole thing, right? That's your direct object. How about indirect object? I will give whoever finishes this first plus points. Whoever finishes this first. This is a clause, right? And this clause just refers to one thing, one person. So whoever finishes it first, for example, you finish it first, then therefore, you is what's going to be replaced there. I will give you plus points, right? But because you'd like to be more specific, so I will give whoever finishes this first. That's indirect object. How about object of the preposition? The event is decided by whatever happens on that day. See the preposition by, right? By what? By whatever happens on that day. That whole clause right there is an object of the preposition. There's also one way you could use it. You could use it also as a subject complement, right? So how does that work? This cat is my pet. Simple. Pet. Pet replaces cat. But if you'd like to be more specific, this cat who I feed and take care of every morning, noon, and night. That cat is who I feed and take care of every morning, noon, and night. Right? That cat. Right? So here, guys, we have this clause, who I feed and take care of every morning, noon, and night. This clause works as a noun, and this is a noun clause. Okay? Alright? So that pretty much ends our topic for recognizing noun clauses. Don't worry, you're not going to be using them in sentences, but I want you guys to recognize them. Identify them immediately in sentences. We'll have more activities in class for you guys to be more used to it. Alright? And that pretty much ends our topic for recognizing noun clauses.